Continue on our quest to finish all the multiple choice questions from the 2003 exam. And so now, today we're going to take a look at two questions, numbers 88 and 89. The first question has to do with the average value function. What you want to do is to make your life a little bit easier. You want to do a little bit of algebra. So change the left side. So I'm going to change the left side so that it says half of the integral from 2 to 4, 4 of f of x dx is equal to 1. We're going to multiply by 2 on both sides. And so we have the integral from 2 to 4 of f of x dx is equal to 2. Once you get to this point, ask yourself a question. The question that you should ask yourself is, what does this mean? It means the area between y equals f of x and the x axis is exactly 2. So not approximately, but exactly. Why is this important? Because it allows us to eliminate two choices. Choice A and choice B, there's no way those are functions. I don't know what the functions are. There's no way I can find the exact area. So eliminate choices A and B right away. The reason is we cannot find the exact area. Not enough information is given. So this is true about choice A and choice B. There's no way I can find this area. Let's move on to choice C. Can I find that area? Let's see it. Draw two vertical lines. This is the area that we're talking about. Let's take a look. What are we talking about? We're talking about the two triangles. If you want to get creative, you can take this triangle, rotate it, put it over here, and form a rectangle. If you don't want to get creative, it does not matter. For both those triangles, the base is 1 and the height is 2. So you have 1 half times 1 times 2 plus 1 half times 1 times 2. We have 1 plus 1. So think about it. You're a calculus BC, a calculus AB student, and you're asked to do 1 plus 1. So we should stop right here. We should, but we will not. We'll review everything else. But clearly, the choice that we're looking for is choice C. Choice C satisfies that we want the area to the curve and the x-axis to be equal to 2. So this equation is made true by the graph in choice C. Let's continue with this anyway. We're going to move to choice E first. For choice E, what you managed to do is you drew a square. The base of the square is 2. The height of the square is 2. 2 times 2. As you can see, the people writing the test have a good sense of humor. The one question said, asked you to find 1 plus 1, and another one asked you to find 2 times 2, which is 4, which is definitely not 2. So it's not choice E. And if you bother to do D as well, in part D, what you're dealing with is a trapezoid. The height is equal to 2. One base is 3. The other base is 1. The area of a trapezoid, might as well review it, is height times base 1 plus base 2 divided by 2. So what are we talking about? Like I said, the height is 2. one base is 1, the other one is 3. This is 2 times 4 divided by 2, and this is also equal to 4. No, 4 is bad. We need the area to equal 2. So this is also not the correct choice. We stop. This problem is now completed.